Hey everybody, I talked at CGI 2020 about the Fong BRDFs, but I thought I'd make a shorter, more fun version. Alright, so the Fong BRDF, right? At its core, you take the reflection vector of the incoming light off of the surface, dot it with a vector to the eye, and raise everything to some power called the specular exponent. Intuitively, this creates a cosine lobe, which turns out to be such a powerful concept it is used all over graphics. The incoming light direction orients the lobe. Of course, since the dot product can sometimes be negative, you have to clamp it to zero, and you need a specular coefficient, and a normalization factor. Oh, and the original Fong BRDF included a Lambertian BRDF too. And I guess the last detail is that Fong's work predated Kajiya's work on the rendering equation, so you have to divide out the geometric term. So really, there's two variants, Fong's original version and some modified Fong version. Anyway, the Fong BRDFs aren't as realistic as flashy, state-of-the-art microfacet models, but Fong is likely still the first specular BRDF you code up in a new renderer or when teaching students, because it's dirt simple to make, it's relatively intuitive, and it actually looks pretty reasonable. So what's the problem? The problem is, about those normalization terms, they ensure that energy is neither created nor destroyed, and no one knows what they should be. Oh sure, there are the answers everyone currently uses. Those answers are, of course, wrong. They're simplifications, producing incorrect results for most cases. In this paper, we show that the correct normalization factors are actually this. Don't freak out, it's not that bad, I promise. In fact, here is the full source code for calculating them. This code is not even 40 lines long, and it works for both BRDF variants. Our work takes only a few nanoseconds per path extra in a compute-bound scene over computing the older, incorrect normalization factors, and is asymptotically faster than the prior work we built upon, which didn't provide a complete solution anyway. We show in the paper how using the correct normalization factors makes the Fong BRDFs maintain energy, and what it looks like visually. The main qualitative effect of this is that energy that was lost at glancing angles is now restored, producing a brighter, more physically correct image. Look at the edges of the object here. So, all in all, if you want to use the Fong BRDFs, you should at least use our version, which conserves energy correctly. We provide the first ever complete normalization terms and show how to compute them. It's fast, easy, and even if it weren't, we provide code. Thanks for listening.